Is Papa John's Takeaway. Can we help you?
I'm looking for Carl Palmer. Does he work there?
Yeah, you've got it. I'm ready for the interview. Let's rock.
Well, I got to say first, it's an honor to be speaking with you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, Carl, let's talk about the tour here, the Carl Palmer's ELP Legacy, Emerson Lake and Palmer Lives On. How's the tour been going so far?
It's been going real well. I mean, we've had a great time so far, a lot of sellouts, which has been really nice. We're looking at, you know, sort of about an hour 55 show. We're playing stuff from all of the albums through the years. We're actually out promoting an album, a live album and DVD, Carl Palmer Live, which was a dedication to Keith Emerson and Greg Lake, a DVD we made down in Florida. So that's the main reason for being out right now. And, we're having fun doing that.
Yeah, and I know you've got an interesting setup with this tour. Can you tell the listeners a bit about who's playing with you and how the shows have been going?
Okay, well, we've got on lead guitar Paul Bjedatovic, who's been with me many years. Now, he's on the live album, along with Simon Fitzpatrick, who also is on the live album, you know, playing bass and Chapman stick. So, we've got a real great sounding band at the moment. We're like very, very pleased the way it's all been going. It's one of our best years yet. As I said, we're playing for an hour, 50 minutes. We're doing some epic pieces like Tarkus and so forth. You know, the real sort of meat and potatoes, should I say, of Emerson, Lake and Palmer, along with things like Trilogy from that, you know, the lead track from that album, Hoedown, Fanfare for the Common Man, and obviously the first hit we had, which was Lucky Man.
Well, and you're going to be coming our way here at the Dakota Jazz Club in Minneapolis on October 30th. It must be difficult to put a set together like that. I mean, you obviously have a lot of stuff you can choose from over the years.
Yeah, well, over the years, we've made a few live albums, and we've tried the music out, and we're down to what we think is the best, you know, of our set. We have two major pieces that we play, and we alternate them from year to year, whether it be Pictures at an Exhibition or Tarkus, which is, you know, a complete sort of like 20-minute piece on its own. So, yeah, it's not difficult, but there is a wealth of material to choose from, yeah.
I know you mentioned you got the live CD, DVD release out. So, you know, if the listeners aren't able to catch you guys live, they can still enjoy the show that way. That's great.
Absolutely, yeah. And we come out after the show, myself, Paul and Simon, and we sign stuff. So, you know, you can get the experience close up and personal, you know.
Well, Carl, you mentioned the show pretty long for what you guys are doing. I know you've been playing some pretty intense music for a long time. How do you stay sharp and continue to play at this high level year after year?
Well, I mean, I'm just enthusiastic about what I do. You know, listen, when you do something that is like, how can I put it to you? I mean, I would do this if I wasn't getting paid for this. You know, it's like that. You know, I would do it because I just love it. And the fact that you love something, you'll always be enthusiastic. You'll always give it a lot of time and a lot of energy. And that's how you become good at what you do, you know. It's not a job. It's a way of life for me.
Awesome. Yeah, I know you're not supposed to mention you'd be doing it for free, but obviously that it definitely helps, you know, after all these years.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, as I say, you need to stay enthusiastic about it. And if you really like something, that's what happens. And that's where I am. And, you know, I just want to bring this music to a new generation of people. Let them see the versatility, how versatile ELP music was, and this is one way of doing it, and, you know, that's successful. It's been successful for a long time now.
Well, Carl, speaking of being successful, I got to ask you about your artwork. Yes. Something that a lot of people maybe don't know that you also got going on. Has that been something you've been doing a long time?
Yeah, I think we're into about 7 years now. The concept started back in 73, but we didn't have computers and digital cameras to be able to progress with the idea, but I've got an art event happening in New York City coming up, so that will be fun. Basically, the artwork that I've produced, 25 to 30% of it has always been donated to various charities, and all of those charities are in the art book which I produced, which is at most of the concerts for people to see. So, you know, we can always look at that, you know, and you can see exactly what's done. In actual fact, it'd be better if your listeners went to the art site, which is carlpalmerarts.com, and you can hear me talking about it. You can actually see it happening. It's all done with drumsticks. It's all it's basically capturing the movement and shadows of light through using LED drumsticks. So it's a bit difficult to explain. It's better to be seen, and then you know I could establish it more with you exactly the procedure. But it's been very successful, and I'm very happy that we've managed to get this far with it.
Yeah, that is great, and it's cool that you're able to incorporate it into the shows and kind of make it all one big Carl Palmer legacy, as you mentioned.
Yes, it's an experience, to say the least.
Well, again, the Emerson, Lake & Palmer Lives On Tour coming to the Dakota Jazz Club in Minneapolis here on October 30th. And Carl, obviously ELP would be enough for most people, but you also had a lot of success with the band Asia. I got to ask, is there anything on the horizon as far as that goes?
Yeah, there are. I can't actually disclose anything yet because there's some new people sort of involved. We're just planning now. We're looking at it seriously. And I would watch out for next summer if I was you.
And I got to ask you, I know you are one of the great drummers of all time. Is there anyone nowadays, any drummers impressing you on the scene now?
Well, you know, I mean, people ask me that all the time. And because the list is so long, I always say, you know, as far as I'm concerned, you know, I've got this procedure where every sort of month I might spend up to 2 hours, 2.5 hours on the internet, on YouTube, investigating new players, new products, stuff that I've gathered throughout the month. And I'm just amazed at the new players that are around and just how many they are and how high the standard is. I mean, not just with drums, but with guitar, with most instruments. I mean, it's really the best it's ever been from the point of view of musicianship and quality, you know, and originality. It's just fantastic. And there are just too many to name.
Well, again, Carl, it's been great speaking with you, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here in Minneapolis. Thank you so much.
Okay, thanks for the interview. Thank you.
All right. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.